everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Kiana and I do a lot of sewing and fashion videos. And today we are going to be making this gorgeous sheath belle sleeve mini dress. Now I do have a pattern for this on my Etsy and that is the first link down below. Also, if you want to see all the supplies and materials needed to make this dress, that is also in the first link down below. Now this dress is a little bit more on the advanced side. However, there are a couple of ways that you can make this a little bit easier for yourself. If you are more of a beginner, I would definitely recommend trying this first without this keyhole in the front. You don't have to use the keyhole because on the pattern I have an option where you can use the keyhole or just leave it as a plain front. So if you're a beginner, I would go with the plain front first. Something really cool about this dress is if you're between sizes, it's really easy to alter the waist because of all the darts. So there are two sets of fisheye darts on the front and two sets of fisheye darts on the back that help easily adjust your waist. So say you're between sizes and your waist is a little bit bigger than what the pattern calls for, it's really, really easy to just make each dart a little bit smaller so that it adds more width to your waist. So that really helps with altering. And for those of you who are subscribed with notifications on, you do get a little reward. So if you are watching this video on the day it's uploaded, you will have until tomorrow night at midnight Eastern time to get this pattern for 30% off. Just use the code keyhole when you're checking out on Etsy with this pattern. If you are not subscribed already, please make sure you are subscribed with the notification bell on so that you can get in on these deals and so that you don't miss an upload. Anyways, if you'd like to learn how to make this dress, then just keep watching. All right, so first things first, print out your pattern at 100% scale. Next up, just place all your sheets of paper right next to each other without overlapping or trimming off any of the paper, and then just tape it together. There are diamonds with letters and numbers inside of them that help you figure out where exactly to line up each sheet of paper. Choose what size to create. I'm deciding to create a US size 2, and then just cut it out. Now just repeat this process on all of your pattern pieces. Next, you want to decide what fabric to use. The main thing here is really choosing something that will drape nicely for the sleeves and that can also be pressed nicely for the darts all over this dress. Pay attention to all of the markings and make sure you notch at all of the triangles and also trace out all of your darts. I'm using tracing paper and a tracing wheel to transfer all of my darts here. Now remember I said this pattern can be a little bit more advanced, especially if you want to do the cutout on the front. So if you're more beginner, I would recommend leaving it and just doing a plain front. But if you're more advanced, go ahead and cut out that keyhole on the corresponding line. I always like to sew my darts first. So first off, I'm just gonna pin those up and then bring it over to the machine to sew it. A little trick I also like to do is if the tracing paper didn't really show up well on your fabric, I'll go back over it with tailor's chalk just to make those darts a little bit more visible so I can sew it more easily. Now make sure you do not skip out on pressing your darts. This is so important, especially if you do not want your darts to pucker. I would recommend grabbing something like a tailor's ham that will let you iron around those curves of the darts more easily. And here's what my darts ended up looking like. It looks nice and clean, especially from the right side. Now, of course, if you're using a solid colored fabric, you're going to be able to see those seam lines way more. But for me with this pattern, it's pretty much invisible. And there are a lot of darts in this pattern. Next, place the dress back to the dress front, right sides together, and sew along the side seams and at the shoulder seams. Sew them, then serge them or finish them however you would like, and then make sure you give everything a really good press. Next up, I'm just gonna prep my self-made bias tape. You can buy your own bias tape, but I really like when mine is matching. So just cut out your bias tape, fold it in half, then fold the two edges towards the center, and then lastly, fold it in half one more time. You are essentially just folding this piece of fabric into quarters. Now this is where it can get a little bit tricky. You're basically going to sew and stretch the bias tape ever so slightly as you sew it around this keyhole. I stretch it more along the curves that are more intense. Now this can be a little bit tricky because I can't tell you exactly what measurement of bias tape you need for this keyhole because it depends on how stretchy your fabric is. And also it's challenging because like I said, you need to stretch it more along the more intense curves than along the rest of it. This is something you kind of learn more just by doing. So if you haven't done this before, I would definitely do a sample first.
When you're doing this, also make sure you're just stretching the bias tape and not the keyhole cutout. I cannot stress this enough. If you stretch the cutout or you straighten out the cutout while you're sewing it to make it easier, you're gonna end up with an extremely puckered keyhole. You want it to lay nice and flat. Now moving on to the collar. So I'm cutting out two collar pieces with my fabric and one with my interfacing. I'm only going to interface one of these two pieces because I don't need it to be a super structured collar, but you can do that if you would like, but I'm not going to. I'm going to line up the center part of my collar with the top of my keyhole. The keyhole should just be barely touching right at the top where the raw edge is. Collars can be tricky because they are reverse curved, so the actual collar will seem like it's a little bit longer than the neckline, but that's not the case. It's just the raw edge is a little bit longer, but the stitch lines are exactly the same. So make sure you're pinning on the stitch lines and that you're not accidentally gathering any of the fabric when you're sewing. Now I'm just going to press the neckline seam up towards the top of the collar so that we can hide this inside the collar later on. Now it is time to add our invisible zipper. So before I insert the zipper, I'm just going to serge the center back seams. I'm gonna pin the zipper along the entire length of it and then just stitch it down. If you need more tips on how to sew an invisible zipper, I will link another one of my videos on at the top of the screen and in the description down below that goes a little bit more in depth if you are struggling. I finished off the center back seam by just sewing along the remainder of that seam line where the zipper ended. Now moving back to the collar, I'm first going to turn and press the bottom edge of the collar upwards a half inch, which is our seam allowance. Then I'm going to place this right sides together to the collar that's already sewn on the dress. I'm just going to pin and sew along the sides and the top of this collar. When you're done sewing, just trim the corners and turn the collar right side out, and it should look like this. Now we just need to stitch down the back part of the collar so it's not hanging loose. To do this, I'm going to follow that seam line, but I'm going to sew about an eighth of an inch away from that seam line in the collar so that I can catch the back part of the collar and keep it secure. Moving on to the sleeves, I'm just going to sew those at the inseam. And one thing I wanna make sure you guys are aware of is that that inseam is cut on the bias, which is the diagonal, which means it's gonna stretch. So see here that the stitch line matches up, but the raw edges do not match up. So make sure you're matching it where you're actually stitching and not where the raw edge is. So see, you don't want to accidentally stretch this inseam to make the raw edge line up because then you're going to end up with some weird ripples in your sleeve. Pinning this is crucial because when you're sewing it, your presser foot's kind of going to give some extra pressure to the top layer of fabric and it's going to want to stretch it out past the bottom layer. So definitely pinning it, sewing it carefully, and making sure that your inseam is not stretching at all. Now we're going to sew two rows of basting stitches in the sleeve cap, starting and ending at the front and back notches. To sew a basting stitch, lengthen your stitch length on your machine all the way, and then just sew inside the seam allowance. Once you do that, you can grab the bobbin threads of your basting stitch and just pull them slightly to give kind of a gathering effect to your sleeve cap, but not too much that it's super noticeable. This is just gonna help ease the sleeve into the arm side. So turn your sleeve right side out and your dress inside out to insert the sleeve into the armhole. Now just use your basting stitches to help ease that cap into the arm side, pin it all together, and then sew and serge around the arm side. Now we're gonna go ahead and hem the sleeves. Now this can be a little bit tricky because it's on a curved hem. So the top part's gonna be easy to sew, but the bottom part is going to be a little bit challenging because of the way it curves. I would definitely, definitely highly recommend pressing this hem before you go anywhere near the sewing machine. It is gonna make your life a whole lot easier. And it's not only a recommendation, but it's basically needed for you to be able to sew this hem. If you want something less challenging, then you can make this belle sleeve into a regular belle sleeve instead of a high-low belle sleeve. Lastly, just go ahead and hem your dress and you have a 1-inch hem allowance. And after that, you are done.
All right, everyone, that is how you make this sheath belle sleeve mini dress. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any pattern requests, definitely leave those down below because I'm kind of gonna be trying to put out a lot more patterns soon. So if you have ideas, let me know. Also, if you like this video, feel free to give me a like. It is the easiest way to support your favorite creators for free. Also, feel free to follow me on Instagram and TikTok. My handle is Kiana Bonolo. Also, don't forget that the pattern for this dress is linked down below on Etsy. It's the first link in the description. What else can I say? Make sure you're subscribed and you have the notification bells turned on. Also, if you don't want to miss out on the sales for my patterns. Yeah, and I think that's everything. So thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.